In this video, we're going to talk about onboarding techniques, what they are conceptually, and cover three popular strategies you can use to help players get through your onboarding funnel. Onboarding techniques are strategies used to help direct players through the onboarding funnel as quickly and seamlessly as possible. An onboarding funnel refers to the amount of players that complete your onboarding experience, called the first time user experience, or FTUE. These are the very first minutes of gameplay that new players experience after they hit play. It's called the onboarding funnel because it's widest at the top, which represents the most amount of player interaction, and narrowest at the bottom, which represents the gap between those who completed the onboarding experience and those who stopped playing. Onboarding techniques aim to close that gap, and there's three onboarding techniques that are really effective at doing this: visual elements, contextual tutorials, and timed hints. Let's start with visual elements. Visual elements are assets or effects that appear in an experience to provide intuitive guidance for navigating and interacting within the environment. This can be done with varying degrees of subtlety. A great example of different types of visual elements can be seen in Hello Kitty Cafe. An example of a subtle visual element would be this directional trail. It shows up during onboarding and strongly suggests where you should go, but still allows you the freedom to make other choices. If you follow that trail, you'll get an example of a more overt visual element in the form of highlighting specific UI elements. Both of these options have their place. Up next are contextual tutorials. Sometimes called just-in-time tutorials, contextual tutorials are tutorials that are triggered by normal play, like when you enter a new map zone or pick up a new weapon. By waiting for players to engage with your experience naturally, contextual tutorials personalize instruction, which maximizes the relevance and utility within the broader onboarding funnel. Squishmallows does this really well. If you get two or more identical squishmallows, a contextual tutorial triggers and shows how to combine three squishmallows at the combination station. Showing this tutorial when it's relevant, when a player is two-thirds of the way towards unlocking a new feature, instead of just including it during onboarding, makes the onboarding process itself shorter and ensures that players won't forget the relevant information by sharing it only when it's needed. Lastly, we have timed hints. Timed hints are tutorial elements that appear to struggling players after a predetermined period of time. You can often identify struggling players by timing how long it takes most players to complete tasks and looking at the players who take longer than most. Timed hints allow designers to create less structured tutorial sequences and add additional layers of help specifically designed to only benefit those who need it most and not annoy those who don't. Doing this helps make sure that the most amount of players can easily get through your onboarding funnel regardless of their skill level. By utilizing onboarding techniques, you can help direct players through your onboarding funnel smoothly, so they can start playing and enjoying your experience as quickly and seamlessly as possible.